people are authority driven. They take the voice of their experts over their own lives.
So your watchword is take a look for yourself. That's
absolutely
what you want to tell. Take
so
a look
what
for
else
yourself.
Do you have there?
These are yes. the pyramids located just to the west of a space on Mars. You can see there's this incredible precise geometry. There's no doubt this was a huge mile wide five-sided pyramid. These guys, who I think were our ancestors, built big.
Hoagland had an even more shocking story to tell. He said that back when he was a network television science consultant, he was inside a NASA control room when the first Mars space probe touched down.
When Viking landed in 1976, I'm standing there looking at a monitor with Carl Sagan. Carl was on my left, some NBC guys are on my right, and we're looking at this first color image come in, downlink, flying from Mars, and it looks like Arizona.
I saw some of the pictures and sense a clear resolution.
So, Mr. President, you know, what we're seeing is a landscape with maybe blue sky and distance.
Then, a few hours later, the head guys sent technicians around to tweak the red knobs on all the monitors in the entire lab. Certain individuals have the political power to keep all of us in the dark about our heritage. They started in 1976 by changing the color of Mars so it would never really look like what it is, which is apparently a lot like Arizona.
An error was made. The Martian sky, the scientists now say, is pinkish.
This is the first color picture of the Viking 2 landing site, proving that this area of Mars is red, just as the Viking 1 site was.
So this corresponds to the real Mars. Look at the sky. It's not pink. It's baby blue.
So NASA had gone to great lengths to hide the fact that Mars' atmosphere is similar to our own, able to support life.
If someone's painting the sky,
they all had to be in on it.
And that would point to an even bigger Mars cover-up.
Is it possible they've already been there, but they haven't told us?
That's part of what we call the secret space program.
What's your personal view about that?
A, it exists. B, they know a hell of a lot more than we know through NASA. And C, there's cover-up after cover-up after cover-up, not only in the NASA area, but in every area.
Hoagland had shown us evidence of life on Mars and of NASA's attempts to suppress it.
He's been tracking this for about 37 years.
He has watched the cover-up step by step with his own eyes. That's what's amazing.
He was there in the control center when the original images, but he was there and he saw the color of the sky and then they changed them a couple of hours.
That's amazing.
But did this cover-up extend to secretly sending men to Mars? We needed another look at some recent history.
What we did have back in the 60s were a manned mission to Mars being planned and then scrapped, right?
Yep.
We began where the public record leaves off, the 1967 NASA program to send men to Mars. Astronaut Brian O'Leary was selected to be on the first flight, but when the program was abruptly cancelled the following year, he hung up his spacesuit and quit. We found O'Leary had moved to South America. He seemed nervous about talking, but we managed to persuade him to speak with us via Skype.
Hi, Brian.
We wanted to find out if Mars was the reason he left his country behind.
It was in 67. Was it that you joined up with NASA for their Mars mission program?
Yeah.
From us, such as I.
We just lost the connection.
had an original seat from a UFO.
Think jump rooms to Mars. The Mars Traveler shows where he took off.
The United States government has had operational teleportation capabilities since 1967.
Family. The team seeks answers in the remote desert and ends up in a dangerous situation.
Get the cameras out of here now.